Hey, I'm Barbara Beery, kids cooking expert and children's cookbook author and working mother, and I know how hard it is to put something delicious and nutritious out on the table in a flash when everybody's walking in the door, tired, hungry, and ready to not think about one more thing. So I'm going to show you two brainless methods that will have you cooking up dinners without thinking about a thing and serving your family delicious food every night of the week. And I cooked up some of this lovely summer squash with some, of course, tiny little julienne carrots, some snow peas, and some onions, a little bit of grated ginger. And you know what? I think it took really chopping, fixing it to this point, maybe 7 to 10 minutes, maybe. And I had all of those things already fixed so that all I had to do was to throw it in that hot pan. Then what you do is that you pour it right on top. And again, the cool thing about this, you could serve this hot straight from the frying pan. You could serve it from the refrigerator if you fixed it the night before, or you could take it out and have it at room temperature anytime. Now you'll also see that in addition to all these delicious vegetables, I've got some of that gorgeous red bell pepper, there is some juice here. And the juice that I used to add a little bit of richness to it was some chicken stock. Now if you wanted to keep it total vegetarian, of course you could use the veggie stock. Now take a look at that. What do you think, Tatum? Would you dig your chomps into that?
Yeah.
Does that look good? Do you like any of those veggies in there?
Mm-hmm.
I think it looks beautiful. You've got orzo. We've got regular brown rice. You've got grits. We have a multigrain. And we also have very many different things that are available now. For instance, this wild rice mix used to be something you'd have to cook for about 45 minutes to an hour. They've got a quick method now with almost as many nutrients, and you can fix that in some stock and give it some extra flavor. The other thing that I love that I didn't start using until just recently is polenta. So the polenta is also a quick fix that you could serve with any veggie, any meat that your family likes, and I think those are all really fast ways to get dinner out in a flash without having to use too much thought to it. Look what a nice job you are doing. Thank you very much. I think your child could be doing this while you're getting the other ingredients ready. That looks so good. This is what I call community garden vegetable soup, and because it has everything in it. It's got potatoes, it's got carrots, it's got corn, it's got green beans, it's got tomatoes, and I also have some vegetable broth in this. I've got these cute little clay pots. Now mind you, clay pots are for plants, right?
Yeah.
And these are clean, but I love clay pots. I bake in them, I bake bread in them, and I've served pudding in them, I've put ice cream in them, and today we're gonna put soup in them. But these little clay pots also have a little hole here. So we gotta stop up that hole with something, and I could think of nothing better than some delicious bread. And we'll put this little thing right here too, so it's got a spot to sit. I'd like you to take a piece of bread, and you have done a great job on that slicing. Put a couple of pieces of bread down in the bottom, because what that's gonna do is to give you a little bit of delicious, soft bread that's all filled with the juices from the soup. But it's also gonna help the soup from going out that little hole. Hold that pot for me. Can you hold it up so I can fill it up over here?
Of course.
Thank you. Oh my goodness, we just had somebody that went over.
Up,
do you peel? Little corn went over too. Now we'll fill this up. I have to tell you, not only is this cute to look at, but it is delicious to eat. And I don't know of a child, I don't know of anybody that wouldn't think this was a pretty cool thing to have for dinner any time of the day. What do you think, Tatum? Would that be a fun thing to eat?
A lovely thing to eat.
Great. Thank you so much for your help. And you know what? If we made another pot of soup, we could put these things right in the soup too, couldn't we?
Yeah.
So I hope I've given you a couple of good methods, slow cooking and fast cooking, that'll help you put dinner out on the table in a flash without having to think too much, and you'll get your kids and your whole family some delicious food every night of the week. Thanks for joining us. Thank you, Tatum. Mm-hmm. See you next time.